friends, I am Mrs. G.S.Zunjarwad, Assistant Professor of Communication Skills, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. All of you are aware that as an engineer, it is very mandatory to have a good knowledge of technical report writing. So in this session today, we are going to discuss about technical report writing. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, student will be able to write a technically effective report. In this session, we are going to discuss about the introduction of a report, definition of a report, then objective of writing a report, and report writing format. So, introduction to technical reports. One of the main forms of communication in engineering is the technical report. In a workplace, the report is a practical working document written by engineers for clients, managers, and other engineers. So it is very necessary to have a knowledge about the definition of a report. So let us discuss what is a report. A report is written on account of something that one has observed, heard, done, or investigated. It is a systematic and well-organized presentation of facts and findings of an event that has already taken place somewhere. Reports are used as a form of written assessment to find out what you have learned from your reading, research, or experience, and to give you experience of an important skill that is widely used in the workplace. So let us discuss what is the main objective of writing a report. Take a pause, think about the question, and try to write the answer. Now, objective. Well, reports vary in purpose and in the type of information they present. For example, site visits, environmental impact or assessment, industrial projects, investigative studies or design projects. All are based on a similar structure and follow similar presentation conventions. So this is an objective or the purpose of report. Now let us discuss about the technical report format. When it comes to the writing of a technical report, the format is very important because it is unique from other reports in that it carries technical information. A technical report contains technical information which should be planned well. You need to understand the structure to achieve your objective. This is a typical structure template for writing a committee report. Whatever the points will be there in this structure, all these points we are going to discuss in detail. So, report format and organization. A technical report should contain the following. First, the title page, then introduction or purpose of the report, then main body, results and discussions, then conclusion or the summary, then recommendations, next, acknowledgement, and the last point is appendix. So first point, title section. This includes the name of the author or the authors and the date of report preparation. This page gives the title of the report, the author's names and student's ID, the unit name and code, the department and university, and the date of submission. So this is a sample of a title section. Now, introduction or the purpose of writing a report. In the introduction, you are supposed to highlight the main aims of the paper or the report to the reader. Let the reader understand the purpose of you writing the report. So, introduction or background, it explains the research problem and its context. It outlines the objectives of the experiment. It identifies pertinent background information. It explains importance of the problem. Why does it matter, or why is more information needed? And it explains reason or the reasons and the goal for the study. It introduces the topic of the report in context. Even it explains the problem and motivation for the project. It states the aim or aims of the project. Even it indicates the purpose of the report, and it gives briefly outlines report structure. This is not necessary in a short report. The next point is main body. The body is the most important part of your report because it carries your content. You should introduce small subheadings in your report as per the point being put across. This will make your work look more presentable, as the reader will be guided with this subheading what point you are talking about. This is the main section of the report. There needs to be several sections, with each having a subtitle. Information is usually arranged in order of importance, with the most important information coming first. Next point is results and discussions. This is where you are expected to explain the results that you obtain from your experiments. You should give a clear explanation so that the reader cannot ask themselves any question on your results. Next one is conclusion or the summary. The conclusion section sums up the key points of your discussion, the essential features of your design, or the significant outcomes of your investigation. As its function is to round off the story of your project, so it should be written to relate directly to the aims of the project as stated in the introduction. It should indicate the extent to which the aims have been achieved. The next point is recommendations. The recommendation usually comes after the conclusion. In recommendation, you are supposed to suggest solutions to the challenges that are there in the body. This is where your opinion is welcome. Next is acknowledgement. In this section, you are supposed to list all the people that help you in coming up with your report. This includes even those that proofread your work to make sure it is well written. This is a way of appreciating the effort of other people in your work. And the last point is appendix. You may have used other materials to put across your points in the report, such as graphs or diagrams, but are not necessarily required in the report. So this is the place where you should mention them. This is the sample of an industrial visit report. Then this is the link you should visit to see the sample document. So in this session, we have discussed about the report writing, technical report writing. These are the links, whatever I have used to make my PPT. Thank you.